This is the first time I've said this, and for those hotel workers and people that get tips, you're going to be very happy, because when I get to office, we are going to not charge taxes on tips, people making tips.
During his rally in Las Vegas, Nevada over the weekend, former President Donald Trump announced that he would do away with taxes on tips for service workers. Look, it was a brief part of his speech, but here's more of what he had to say.
And we're going to do that right away, first thing in office, because it's been a point of contention for years and years and years. And you do a great job of service, you take care of people, and I think it's going to be something that really is deserved. More importantly, popular or unpopular, I do some unpopular things too if it's right for the country, I do what's right. But so those people that have jobs in restaurants, whatever the job may be, a tipping job, we're not going after for taxes anymore. This will be ended. And I announced that for the first time. First time I've brought it up. First time anyone's brought it up. I think it's never been brought up before. And I also think it's very appropriate.
Okay, so let's break this down into two different categories. And it's important to know the distinction. There's politics and then there's policy. Politics is about the optics, it's about personal marketing. And then the policy has to do with whether or not this is something that's even doable, whether or not Trump is actually serious about this. So we'll get to that in just a moment. But first, let me just say, this is good politics. I know, I'm not supposed to give him any credit for anything. Come at me if you'd like, but this is good politics. This is exactly the kind of rhetoric that appealed to voters back in 2016. And it seems like Trump is really going back to his greatest populist hits, right? Making it appear as though he's an individual who cares deeply about working class Americans. And when it comes to marketing, I hate to admit it, he's far better than Biden is. He's far better at marketing himself and saying things that appeal to ordinary Americans. And I think that is what is carrying him in all of these polls that we've been discussing on the show. So look, he's signaling an economic populist message that seeks to make economic conditions a little better for ordinary Americans, especially at a time when inflation is still crushing Americans. Okay, it just is, it's not getting any better. The Federal Reserve has made clear that while they planned on lowering interest rates, it looks like they're gonna have to postpone that. And remember, Trump tends to have some pretty great instincts when it comes to marketing himself to working class Americans. And when that awful train derailment happened, that Norfolk Southern train derailment that occurred in East Palestine, Ohio, Trump was smart enough to realize, hey, maybe I should go visit the local community there, whereas Biden refused to do so. Let's watch.
What's your specialty today?
How are you today? Nice to meet you.
Hello, everybody. That's a nice, beautiful looking group of people. So I know this menu better than you do. I probably know it better than anybody in here. We're going to take care of the fire department.
Okay.
We're going to take care of the police department.
Pausing here to deliver some honest truth as we do in our news coverage as well. TYT is facing challenges, guys, as the entire industry is. You know who could make the difference? You. If you hit the join button below, it's gonna make all the difference and keep us in business. We appreciate you, thank you.
So Trump shows up, he buys fast food for the first responders in the community. Biden, who's obviously president at the time of this derailment, did not visit East Palestine until a year later. Now, let's talk about the actual policy. You know, Trump is known to just say things when he doesn't even really necessarily mean it. So it's hard to tell how serious he is about this. Was he just saying it to appeal to people, or is it something that he actually plans to work on if he gets elected? I have no idea, and you can only speculate on that. However, policy-wise, he can't just do this unilaterally. This is tax policy. It's something that would need to be carried out through Congress. Now, Congress might actually consider it though, because remember, they're going to revisit Donald Trump's tax cuts because there are certain provisions within the 2017 tax cuts that are going to expire soon. So Congress is going to convene and try to figure out ways to make certain provisions permanent, or at least to extend those provisions. Now, lawmakers will look at the nation's tax policy next year upon the expiration of Trump's 2017 Tax Cuts and Jobs Cut Act. The 2017 Tax Cuts Act did not include provisions on tips, but if Republicans retake the White House and Senate and hold the House, they would have the opportunity to add to and extend Trump's previous policies. And look, I'm gonna just be honest, I would be okay with cutting taxes for tips, especially in states where they do have that tipped wage. In states like California, there is no tipped wage. Everyone in California makes at least the minimum wage in California. So it's a little different in California, but there are other states where you make like a couple dollars an hour, but most of your income comes from tips. I don't know if I would eliminate, you know, taxes on tips entirely, but a little bit of a tax break for service workers, especially since service workers make up the bulk of workers in this country, would be a nice change from the massive tax cuts that the rich keep getting, okay? So I would not be offended by a policy that focuses on giving ordinary American workers a little more relief. But I do want to give you some ideas of the provisions that members of Congress are going to be hyper focused on. They're not going to be hyper focused on giving service workers relief. They're going to be hyper focused on extending or making permanent certain provisions that overwhelmingly benefit high earners. So the biggest tax cut that's expiring is the lower tax rates and the wider brackets. So just to give you an idea, the top tax rate fell from 39.6% to 37% for the highest earners. And so that is what the lawmakers want to extend, or at least make permanent. The tax breaks for the estate tax, well, that's gonna expire too. So they're gonna be hyper focused on making that permanent or extending it. And then there's the standard deduction, which actually does benefit ordinary people. Well, that is also going to expire without congressional action. But interestingly enough, the Culinary Workers Union Local 226, which is based in Las Vegas, criticized Donald Trump's pledge, which surprised me. The union secretary treasurer, a guy named Ted Papa George, which is a fun last name, let's keep it real, released a statement saying relief is definitely needed for tip earners, but Nevada workers are smart enough to know the difference between real solutions and wild campaign promises from a convicted felon. So I suppose the man with the real solutions is supposed to be Joe Biden, and we're gonna get back to him in just a moment. But interestingly enough, there was a CBS News reporter, Olivia Rinaldi, who talked to some of the workers in Las Vegas to get a little bit of a read on how they felt about what Trump had to say during his rally speech. And here's what she had to say.
I did talk with some hotel workers yesterday, some service workers here in Las Vegas, about how that is playing with them. And Anne-Marie, about six people told me that would change their vote. That is enough to make them switch from voting Democrat to Republican if Donald Trump is promising something like that to them.
So I don't know what's going on with the, you know, culinary union's leadership. I don't know if that individual actually speaks for the workers within that union, or if this is an individual who despises Donald Trump and refuses to give him any credit for a proposal that might actually be beneficial for the service workers in Nevada. But, you know, just based on the anecdotal evidence from that CBS reporter, there are obviously some workers in Las Vegas who found that proposal appealing and would literally change their votes over it. Now, to go back to Biden and how he differs from Trump, you know, as we heard from Papa George, Biden has the real solutions. And so let's talk about what those real solutions are. So Biden did do something that was good, and I don't think he got much credit for this. In fact, as I was researching for this story, I came across this information and realized I was not informed on it. I wish it got more attention. But he did manage to reverse a Trump era rule dating back in 2021. He reversed this Trump era rule that basically screwed over tipped workers, okay? What it did was it limited employers. What Biden did, limited employers and what they could pay workers when it came to certain jobs, right? Like, it's hard to explain, but Biden reversed a Trump era rule in 2021 that limited when employers can pay workers the lower tipped minimum wage for performing non-tipped tasks. So this sounds super complicated, but let me give you more context. So the Trump administration finalized a rule that scrapped the 80-20 regulation that said employers can pay the tipped minimum wage of $2.13 an hour for non-tipped tasks performed contemporaneously or immediately before or after workers' primary tip duties, regardless of how much time they take. So this ended up saving employers a ton of money. And Biden came in and he reversed it because he realized it was actually screwing over service workers. So Biden came in, he reversed it. The Department of Labor's wage and hour division under Biden says workers can only be paid the tipped minimum wage. Again, that's the $2.13 amount for tasks that directly support tipped work and do not take up more than 20% of a worker's time or 30 consecutive minutes. Major business groups back the Trump era rule, saying that keeping track of the precise amount of time workers spent on different tasks was unworkable. But worker advocates claim the changes would cost tip workers hundreds of millions of dollars in wages. So there you have it. Biden did something good. He deserves credit for that. But here's where Biden does not deserve credit. And it drives me crazy when people try to give him credit for this, because we just experienced what his presidency is like, and he did not fight for any of these things. Biden has also pushed, allegedly, according to The Hill, for increases to the federal minimum wage and phasing out the tipped minimum wage for restaurant service workers. Really? When? When did he do that? When did Biden push to increase the federal minimum wage? He caved on that immediately, early on in his term. And honestly, when did Biden ever fight to do away with the minimum wage for service workers, for tipped service workers? When did that ever happen? Maybe I missed it. I looked for it. I'm like, oh, maybe Biden did fight for that. Let me look into it. Maybe he gave a rousing speech about how, oh, tipped workers are getting paid too little in their hourly wages. No, nothing. He didn't fight for it. He didn't push for it. He doesn't deserve credit on it. But look, again, there's optics, there's the politics, and then there's the policy. And when it comes to the politics, you are lying to yourself if you are of the mind that Biden is doing a better job in marketing himself to ordinary working class Americans compared to Trump. Trump might be lying, Trump might be full of crap, and he has lied a lot in the past. But he does know about the economic anxieties that Americans are facing, and he knows how to hit them on the issues that matter most. In the meantime, I don't know where Biden is. He's wasting his time assisting, aiding and abetting the brutality that's being, you know, waged against the Palestinian people in Gaza. He's demanding tens of billions of dollars for wars abroad, hundreds of billions of dollars, in fact. And it's just really not good, optically speaking, for the American people as they look at their current conditions. They see how inflation is impacting their households, and they're wondering, okay, who's the real leader here? Is it the guy who's more concerned with wars abroad? Or is it the guy who's giving a speech about cutting taxes for service workers? These are hard truths, I get it. We're supposed to say Trump bad, Trump convicted felon, but Trump knows how to campaign, and he certainly does it better than Biden does.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.